Well, Rich Tamboris tells us he's not so sure about telling drivers to slow down anymore after last evening. He says when his neighbor's car initially drove up, he thought he might be apologizing, but that was far from what happened.
I thought he was going to shoot. I'm surprised when I was fighting with him, a gunshot didn't go off. I really thought a bullet was going to come flying and hit me.
Rich Tamboris says the run-in with this man, 21-year-old Kurt Whittingham, was on his mind all night. It ended with a gun pointed at his face.
He speeds by my house and revs his engine constantly and then peels out around the corner, and I tell him to slow down.
After a month of yelling at him to stop, on Monday night, Tamboris had had enough and stood in the middle of Sherwood Drive and stopped Whittingham, again asking him to slow down.
Didn't even look at me. He just drove away and finally drove away slow without spinning his wheels or nothing.
Tamboris thought it was over, but a half hour later, he says Whittingham drove back. Tamboris thought he might apologize.
I don't see very well, and it was night, and his headlights were beaming in my face, so when my eyes finally focused, I realized I was looking down the barrel of a gun.
With no time to think, Tamboris says he reached for the gun.
Like this far away from me, in my face, and I just grabbed his arm and pushed it up, and then he finally freed his arm. And then when he finally got the gun away, he's like, "You can't put your hands on me." And I'm like, I never touched him until he had a gun in my face.
Whittingham's version of the story is much different. He calls Tamboris the crazy neighbor in court paperwork and says Tamboris reached in, grabbed me by the arm, punched me in the face, so I took my gun off the passenger seat and tried to hit him with it. Despite that account, Whittingham was charged with felony criminal threatening. Tamboris still can't believe how this escalated.
I wasn't expecting a gun in my face. Not for telling somebody to slow down on a 20-mile-an-hour street.
Whittingham is being held on $50,000 bail and will be back in court next month. Reporting live, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.